خير الراحمين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لبسني إما وينور كرسمي نالج.
Fasting encourages prayers, giving alms, and doing many other good deeds, and refraining from evil.
Hadrat Ibrahim alayhi salam's prayer to offer everything to his Lord. The righteous people have been advised in the Holy Quran to follow the example of Hadrat Ibrahim and offer this prayer. رَبَّنَا عَلَيْكَ تَوَكَّلْنَا وَإِلَيْكَ أَنَبْنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرُ. Our Lord, in you do we put our trust, and to you do we turn repentance, and towards you is the final return.
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. The Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that Ramadan is a great and blessed month in which nights are for worship of God. It is a month to practice patience, and the reward for patience is paradise. It is a month in which the believer's provision is blessed. In this month, Allah rewards each obligatory act 70-fold. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد.
Prayer for mercy. On the same occasion, Hazrat Moses alayhi salam prayed for forgiveness for his brother and himself. رب اغفر لي ولي أخي وأدخلنا في رحمتك وأنت أرحم الراحمين. My Lord, forgive me and my brother, and admit us to your mercy. And you are the most merciful of all those who show mercy.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Prayer for being steadfast in guidance. Hazrat Salama Raziatala Anha relates the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to often recite this prayer. O the one who can turn the hearts, make my heart firm in your faith. She narrates that she asked the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam whether their hearts can change. He replied that the following Quranic prayer should be recited and said that as there was a possibility of stumbling, so this prayer should be recited frequently.
رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِي قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَي إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب.
Translation. Our Lord, let not our hearts become preserved after you have guided us and bestow upon us mercy from yourself. Surely you alone are the bestower. Jazakallah.
Once the promised Messiah was asked about fasting while traveling. The promised Messiah, alayhi salam, replied, As far as the Holy Quran is concerned, it says, Whoso among you is sick or is on a journey shall fast the same number of other days. This means that a sick person or a traveler must not fast. This is an order, and there is no other option from God Almighty. In my view, a traveler should not fast. However, some people do keep fasts as a matter of course, and if they do so while traveling in pursuit of this practice, there is no prohibition, although one must have still regard for the injunction, shall fast the same number of other days. A person who goes to considerable trouble in keeping a fast while traveling tries to please God by force rather than earning his pleasure by following his commandment. This is a big mistake. True belief consists of following the injunctions and prohibitions of Allah. Majmu' Fatwa Ahmadiyya, volume 179.
Rabbi ighfir warham wa anta khayrur rahimin.